We're coming up on 5:30 in the morning. It is Friday, November 16th. Good morning. I'm Lauren Simonetti.
And good morning. I'm Jerry Willis. Well, it was volatility on Wall Street, but not the good kind. The Dow, or it was the good kind, pardon me. Ultimately, the Dow Industrial swinging another 500 points, ending up 208, yay, as tech stocks rallied. What's ahead for the stock market as 2018 starts to wind down? Let's bring in Melissa Armo of StockSwoosh.com and David Ragland, CEO and investment strategist of IRC Wealth. Good morning to you both. Great to have you here. Melissa, I want to start with you, my friend. If we can get through next week, might there be a rally in the offing?
I really think the market has a chance to do it. Now, we're down a little bit this morning, but we were yesterday, too, and we hung on. So if the market can hang on today and get into next week, which is a holiday week, which is typically slow for the market because it's closed on Thursday and a half day on Friday. You only have really three full trading days, and a lot of people leave early on Wednesday. Big institutional traders, they leave early for the holiday Wednesday. I think the market's going to make it into the final week of November and then possibly rally. Because remember, we have that summit. We have
that G20
summit.
I'm just going to get to that, Melissa, to David. You know, yesterday's market was like being a seagull in a windstorm. It was up, it was down. We were all over the place. But I'm looking forward to that G20 meeting that Melissa just mentioned. Could that be something that could spoil the party? We'll be looking for trade talks, some good news, some positive news on trade talks with China. What do you see?
Well, I think we've got really the ingredients for a fantastic Christmas rally here. We've got a strong consumer. We have got lower valuations. And
what about
that
G20 meeting, my friend?
We exactly going there right now, thinking that we got potentially big upsides if we get just a little bit of good news out of the trade talks, or maybe just a little good news from the Fed saying he's not going to raise interest rates quite as strong in 2019.
Well, you know, anytime we get positive news on trade, the markets just go through the roof. That is absolutely true, David. Melissa, I want to talk to you about retail. I know you're very interested in that sector, and I paid a lot of attention yesterday when Walmart had that great report and didn't really get any reward for it. They had internet sales up 43%. It really looked good. What do you make of retail? Could this lead us higher?
Well, I got to be honest with you, Walmart's chart looks pretty good despite the fact that it fell on earnings. Walmart and Target are two of the specific retailers that compete against Amazon that are both in uptrends. Amazon's in an uptrend, Walmart's in an uptrend, and Target's in an uptrend. And then when you look at those retail stocks compared to the likes of JCPenney, Nordstrom's down from last night on earnings, and Macy's is lower too. Macy's is in a downtrend. I still like Walmart, even though it really wasn't a buy yesterday on earnings. But going into the holiday season, typically these stocks could rally. Target and Walmart could rally in the next between now and the end of the year. Macy's, I just think, didn't do it.
Those department stores still having a lot of trouble. David, I'm curious what you think is going to be the next leadership in the market. Everybody's talking about this question. Is it value? Is it industrials? What is the next sector that's really going to take a leadership role?
Well, I think you've got big value. You've got the companies out there that have extremely strong balance sheets so that they can weather the increase in the rates, but they're still at lower PE prices. So certainly feel like in an economy that the interest rate starts to move up, the techs may lag with the big values showing major strength.
All right, guys, thanks for that. Great information. Appreciate your time, Melissa and David.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Have a good weekend.
Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg is pushing back.